Hello, and welcome to the View from IMF video series 2021. The annual meetings this year will be covering a lot of different topics, but one of the most impressive topics will be around sustainable finance as we move through to the COP26 meeting in Glasgow later this month. I'm Joy McKnight, editor of The Banker, and I'm joined by Marianne Haahr, who is executive director of the Green Digital Finance Alliance, to talk about sustainable digital finance. Marianne, thanks so much for joining me.
Thank you so much for the invitation.
So obviously a lot of people talk about sustainable finance. How do you define sustainable digital finance?
Yeah, that's really where digital finance and sustainable finance intersect, right? So it's the application of fintech to align financial and capital flows with the needs of sustainability. So it ranges from digital capital market instruments, such as tokenized green bonds, to green robo-advisors, where you get a green investment journey facilitated by artificial intelligence, to retail payments that integrates automated carbon footprinting on your purchases.
So what role do you think that fintechs can play in really delivering on the UN Sustainable Development Goals?
Fintech can play a number of roles, which is really addressing the current barriers to scaling green finance or sustainable finance. So if we look at sort of two main roles, then the first one is really getting more and better data to inform financial decision making, so you can do capital reallocation towards sustainability outcomes. So it, where we see it in the market today is really you see a lot of fintech tools that are enabling ESG rating of companies using AI that reads automatically disclosed reports together with it's web scraping, where they pick up sentiments about companies, but also automatically read expert reviews and reports, and thereby gives a company an ESG score. But what we're seeing fintech now starting to do is actually to take that next step and layering in also an observed data layer, which is not only disclosed, but also go in and leverage satellite imagery, et cetera, to really also look at the real green behaviors of a company and layer that into, so for instance, going into the big satellite data repositories of Sentinel-2 or Landsat, so the European Space Agency or NASA, and really tag a company to see, well, is there deforestation in the portfolio? So if you are an investor with a net deforestation target, that you can navigate away from that company or you can engage with that company. So really a shift from sort of only focusing on self-disclosure to also layering in new data layers. So more and better data. And the second one I wanted to focus on is really around rethinking scaling and that by innovating capital market instruments. So today, a lot of the green assets are too small for capital market requirements to issue a bond, for instance. But digital can really lower the transaction cost. So even smaller green assets can issue a tokenized bond and thereby raise capital more efficiently and cheaper than if they were only in the private markets.
And what is the concept around fintech for impact?
Yeah, the concept of fintech for impact, we know fintech, right? And if we look at it in three waves, then fintech is just in the first wave, it was just about digitizing existing financial products and services. So basically giving loans to people that were outside of the bank system, so financial inclusion. Then the second was really to say, okay, let's start to use data to innovate new types of financial products. So for instance, fractional ownership of an asset. So you could crowd in people's savings into asset classes that was reserved for big institutional investors before. And now we're really seeing the third wave, which is exactly the answer to your question, which is fintech for impact. And that is really to leverage data and digital capabilities to innovate new types of financial products that are much more aligned with sustainability, and also that renders existing green and sustainable financial products more efficient, because if they're not digitized, they tend to be less cost efficient than non-financial products.
And my last question is around a new initiative, which is a Every Action Counts Coalition. What are the aims behind that?
The Every Action Counts Coalition is really to rethink scaling. So what it is that it brings together fintech, so mobile payment platforms, e-commerce platforms, etc. And they congregate around the shared vision to empower 1 billion citizens by 2025 with green awareness and green actions. So basically to leverage their transaction data to give people automated feedback on the greenness or the carbon intensity of their everyday actions. I mean, we're inspired, of course, by Ant Forest in China, which today has reached 600 million people with automated carbon feedback on 20 behaviors, and then really created a game around that. So green becomes sort of the new socialized norms, and then that it rewards you to shift your lifestyle towards carbon lighter. So we're bringing together a global coalition of fintech players to basically look at their own digital and data capabilities and say, how can we bring some of that same automated feedback to our users, and then also new types of incentives to shift behaviors, because we know information in itself does not shift behaviors. You need incentives, whether it's reward points or what it is, whether it's social incentives. So that is really what the Every Action Count Coalition is about. It's about scaling green actions from below.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your insights, Marianne.
Thank you so much for inviting me.